But I think what definitely merits a response is now that you are in Mumbai, let's put this in front of you. Bangalore or Mumbai? Faye?
Bangalore.
Oh, really?
Outside of question. Bangalore.
Okay. And of course, in Bangalore, what were the places you used to hang out when you were in college? Like, where did you go?
So I studied in Mount Carmel, right? So everyone who studied in Mount Carmel spends a lot of time in Vasad Nagar, which is just down the street where we'd walk. And
it's called Loafer Street.
It's called Loafer Street for good reason. Now, of course, Vasad Nagar has become very cool. I was there, just before the lockdown. I was doing some fundraising and I had a meeting and a couple of meetings in the Cunningham Road, Vasad Nagar neighborhood. And now there are like really cool places there. But back then there was one cake shop and there was one guy who was like gobi manchurian, which you'd eat with like a toothpick.
With toothpick, a yeah. After that, the color stays on your hand for like days. You know what I mean?
Which is why you use a toothpick.
When you're hungry, it doesn't matter, Faye.
Technically, our gobi manchurian thing that is me. Yeah, really good.
Okay, so of course, you also love interacting with younger people. All right. So what would be your message to young people out there who are aspiring to achieve various things in these times? What would be your message to little young people out there?
So, there's a lot being said about, and I honestly believe this, there's a lot being said about, you should be using this time to acquire a new skill, to learn a language, to better yourself and all of that. I think this is a difficult time that we're going through emotionally. It's a difficult time psychologically for all of us.
Yeah.
It's physically a difficult time for a lot of people who are living alone, who don't know how to cook. It's a good time to cook. It's a good time to learn that. But I think the focus should right now be on just making it through. Don't put pressure on yourself of, I've not done as much as this other person who's constantly posting about how they've like done something cool or learned something cool, or they're constantly improving themselves. Do not allow social media to put pressure on you to be like everybody else.
Sure.
Just survive. The only goal here should be to survive. Once you've got that down and you've figured out how you're keeping yourself safe, how you're keeping your home safe, how you're going to feed yourself, how you're going to look after yourself, then I would say your second point should just be to look out with compassion to the people around you. Sure. Find those who need our help. The best part about being young right now is that you have access to all your faculties, which means you can walk and you can run and you can walk and you can drive and you can do all of these things. And there are so many people who can't do any of these things. So figure out if there's an elderly person in your building who could use your help. Figure out if there's someone in your life who can use your help. Do not do anything stupid with your money right now. Save your money. This is like my genuine ask of all young people.
You were planning on starting a financial little segment on your this thing, right? Am I right?
Yes.
Sorry, go on.
So we don't know, and this is the reason why, right? We don't know, and I'm being blunt and honest, if any of us will have the jobs that we have right now after the lockdown. We don't know. We also don't know that if you do have your job, if you will continue to have the same pay. It's very likely it's one or the other will happen, that we'll either lose our jobs or we will receive pay cuts, in which case your money is going to mean something completely different from where it is right now. So it's really important, first of all, and you're feeling, so basically what's happening is because you're sitting at home and you're not going out, so you haven't gotten a drink for 30, 35 days, you've not gone out partying, you've not had a 300 rupee cup of ridiculously expensive coffee. So you've saved all that money. So right now you feel like, hey, I have a lot of money. Let me invest in the stock market. It's a terrible idea. This is a false sense of saving. It's a forced saving. Sure. You feel like you're okay because you have money in your account. This is not how it's going to be 2-3 months down the line when this lockdown ends.
I understand.
Save your money as much as you can. Be more aware of your money. Be more careful of your money. And just
survive.
Just chill.
Yeah.
Survive. Just survive. And we will figure it out. You know, we will figure it out when the ground stops shaking, because right now we don't know when this is ending. We don't know how long the lockdown is going to continue, when we're going to be able to go back to work, what work is going to be like also. So just chill. Don't do anything. Just make it through. That's my advice to young people.